Hey everybody, it's Christine getting ready to start our next shelter in place workout. As always, want to go over a couple different things. Want to make sure that you are wearing good supportive sneakers with a good arch support that are comfortable on your feet. Anything that happens at your foot can go off the chain, creating problems at your ankles, knees, hips, back, all the way up. Let's avoid all that. So if you pronate, supinate, have a neutral foot, make sure you're wearing the right appropriate shoe. As always, want to make sure that you're well hydrated and have had proper nutrition before beginning today's class. Want to make sure that you're going to have enough energy to get through the entire workout and still feel good at the end. For today's class, we will be using some hand weights and a ball. Alright, so I tend to use a lighter hand weight. I have a couple different sizes, different weights. I tend to do higher repetitions, better for building, for toning the muscles. If you want to build a bigger, stronger muscle, you will need to use a heavier weight. Make sure that you use the appropriate size for yourself. If you're compensating on how your mechanics are, the weight is too heavy. Drop it down. You're going to use a ball or a pillow. Go out. Don't buy anything new. Use what you got. All right? You can also use the weight in place of the ball, so that's an option as well. For today's class, as always, we do a 5 to 8 minute warm-up, getting the body prepared for the main set of exercises, warming up the muscles, the joints, getting everything ready, because when we start, it's going to be continuous movements, all right? So we will be using the weights today. We will be using the ball. We'll be doing a lot of various exercises, working on core stability, strength, balance, core. All right. When we end on a stretch. Typically, it is one repetition. You want to hold 2 to 3 repetitions. 2 to 3 per side is optimal. We are going to get ready to start on that high knee march. If you prefer a different type of warm-up, you're going to do an indoor bike. You're going to dance. Do whatever you like, all right? Just keep moving. Bring it wide. Reach. Remember, it's your class. You do what feels comfortable and good for you, all right? One more. Bring it out wide. Elbow up towards the knee. One more. Opposite elbow, opposite knee. Arms out, circle. One more. Hold. Press it up. In and out. And bring it up by your ears. Triceps. Squeeze that belly and bum. Ten by your side. Kick back. Shoulders are back. Six, seven, elbows high. Eight, nine, ten. Turn the palms. Kick. Kick. Tricep. One more. Low circles. We're gonna go over squat technique. Shoulders and knees, all right, same width. Knees are gonna be facing forward, toes forward. Shoulders and head looking straight ahead. When you come down, your glutes are out. Up and down, guys. One more. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Seven, eight, nine. Hold it down. Toe tap. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Balls up. One, two, three, four. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Heel raise, opposite. Heel raise. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Double up. One, two, three, four. It's ankle five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Bring it up. Turn them out, 11 and 1. Toes up and down. Hold it down. 1. Of arms. All right, you can always add on. You don't want to get hurt when you start. You can start with the hands by your side and do a bicep curl. Up, raise, forward, curl, up, tricep, down, butterfly, bicep curl, butterfly, in, Let's go. First, you never feel bad. Remember, you can always challenge yourself. No one's saying don't do that. You want to make sure that what you're doing feels good and comfortable, but challenging. That's three. Watch your posture. Squeeze that belly and bum. Back is straight. Up and down. You're always working your core, no matter what we're doing for an exercise. Finish out the set. All right, single leg standing, drawing out our sword, going up and over. Yeah, it's a little bit of core work, arm work, stab work. You got this. So for balance, right, we can either do a toe tap, toe touch forward, tap back, out to the side, or up. Let's go. Up, sword out, up, one, halfway, one more, other side, set it up, toe tap, wide or up. Go. Applesauce makes one. forehead, down, up, triceps. One more. Standing on one leg again, arms are gonna be by your side or crossed over your chest. We're gonna kick the leg forward for 10. Up, up, one round halves. 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Toe and knee face forward, bring it out. Out, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, kick it back, toe is back to start, squeeze your glutes, up. Do some bird dog. All the way down. One weight, one hand, one leg. All right. Opposites, not the same leg, the same hand. All right. So you can either have both knees flat down, level one. Level two, bring that leg up. With or without a hand weight. Keeping that back flat. You're going to go up for a set of 10. We're going to go out for a set of 10, up, row, back, and down. The whole sequence makes one. Ready? Up, out, row, back, one. Make sure y'all looking straight down, neck in a good alignment. One more. And other side. Squeeze that glute. Get that arm out. Legs out. Let go. Up. Out. Row. Going to be on our forearms. We're going to do hip drops 10 times on one side. You can do it on your knees. I'll show you the first variation. Get down and plank. Hip up. Feet are flat. Second level. Knees are up. Our heels are up. All right. Third way. Here. Hip up. All right. We're going to do 10. One side, 10 the other. Then we'll alternate. Get in position, pick your poison. Let go. Bring it down. Down.
Full plank.
Nine. on your back, get that ball. Get your hand weights. Squeeze that ball between your knees. Arms up and down. Here we go. Ready, bum up. Chest press. 9, 10. Hold your hips up. Squeeze that ball. Hands face each other. Over. Over. Center. Small movement. Cage up and down. Reverse row. One more. Bring them out wide. Butterfly. Up and down. Wide. Out. Squeeze that belly and bomb.
I'm gonna
Make sure all y'all breathing. One more. Remember our toe raises, right? Get a drink. Next one, with or without your weights. We're gonna be doing a squat. Overhead heel raise, overhead shoulder press. So what you're gonna do, feet are gonna start close together. Bring it down, overhead press. Up, one, two. Lift up on those heels. Six, seven, 8, 10, squat, out, squat, center, dead bug now. We already did bird dogs.
Since you came along.
So squeeze your belly and your bum, get that back so it's flat. You're gonna have your legs up into a chair position. Arms are in chair position. What we're gonna do is 1 foot down and up. 10 times. Down. 2. Squeeze that belly and bum. You wanna make sure that your back stays flat.
Seven. Eight.
One more. Seven, eight, nine, and 10. All right. Gonna sit on up. Put that ball out of the way. Put the weights out of your way. Time to stretch. Remember what I said in the beginning, right? 2 to 3 repetitions, 30 to 60 seconds each side, each time. We'll be going over one repetition. You have the ability to pause, hold longer, do your multiple sets. First one you're gonna do, legs are out, toes and knees pointing toward the ceiling, gently walking your hands down toward the middle and hold. Stretching your adductors, inner thigh muscles. All of the exercises we do are to build core strength, glute strength, power. You want to be able to have a nice strong core in order to do all the activities you want to get back to, whether it's running, biking, hiking, swimming. You have to have a strong core in swimming. You know, everything comes off the core for them. You know, if you don't have a strong core, the arm movements aren't going to be synchronized. You're going to have struggles out there. Just saying. But, you know, it's supposed to be fun. You're supposed to enjoy what you're doing. Bring it on up. Reach for the toe. So whatever you enjoy doing most, enjoy yourself, have fun, that's what keeps you going, right? If it's not fun, why do it? I'm kind of crazy, I enjoyed the exercise. So, for me, this has always been fun. Talk a lot, hopefully that distracts you a little. Bring it on up, reach over and hold. Back is straight, toes and knees are still facing the ceiling. Through your spine. Feet are together, dropping those knees down. Chest is high, back is straight. So we're not slumped, okay? That's not doing anything good for you. If you have the flexibility and you have a lot of range of motion like I do, you can lift up your toes. It's gonna deepen that stretch. If your knees are up here, there is no point in trying to lift those toes. You gotta do it with good form, okay? You don't wanna hurt anything. Legs out front, shake them out, soft knees, looking straight ahead, reaching toward your toes for the back of the hamstrings, and hold, and breathe. Hopefully got a little sweat on today. You don't have to do a ton of jumping in order to get that to happen. You just gotta work those muscles hard. You should be feeling this behind the knees, and your calf, and all the way up through the back. One knee over in toward the center of midline. Your hip is on the floor. Back is straight. You're not doing a spinal twist, you're doing a glute stretch, piriformis muscle. Up nice and tall and hold. Toes up. Everything's about how your form is. If you're turning, then you're doing a different kind of stretch, not necessarily the one we're focusing on. Be mindful of your movements. If anything hurts, don't do it. Message me, let me know. I'll give you an alternate. Bring it on down, cross All right, I'm gonna bring those legs out. You're gonna come up onto one knee. Stretching out the hip flexor on the leg that is back, and hold. Stretching right here in front of that hip. Squats, lunges, side lunges. All sorts of fun stuff getting to that area. You gotta make sure you keep it lengthened, all right? Even the bridging, when you go up tall, you know, lifting the hips up, it stretches into that area. Other leg. Remember, 30 to 60 seconds. Pause, hold, 2 to 3 repetitions. I do have other videos that do have full body stretching only. It's a 15 and a half minute, 16 minute video. So if you go out for a long run, a ride, whatever, you're feeling tight, take the time, give yourself a little extra. It's your classes, you know, do that stretch. You need more of a challenge? I have a ton of variety in there. I got a lot of challenges. Bring it on up. We have Dance Monkey as a challenge. We have Roxanne. We have, oh geez, Cupid Shuffle. We have the Wobble. I got a lot of them. Look them up. There's like 5 or 6 in there. Plus I keep adding on. I keep creating some. I think it's fun. Make sure that back foot is nice and straight. Knee is straight. Heel is flat to the ground. Other side, slide it back. Arm out. Cross it over and hold. Just want to give a shout out to my peeps. Peace, love. Couldn't do this without you guys. Your support, your encouragement. Y'all bless me. Bring it up tall. Arm up and over and cross and hold. Toes, knees forward. You inspire me. Why we're a team, guys. Bring it up and over. Other side. And reach. Bring it back up into the middle. Press out of the rib cage. Bring it down to the side. Head tilt. I want to thank you all for joining me. As always, my pleasure. You guys inspire me to keep going, keep doing these classes. It's a strange time in our lives, isn't it? Bring it back up into center. Breathe in. One more time. Just want to thank you for your continued support and for joining me. Give me a great big hug. I'm giving you a great big hug. Pat yourself on the back. You did it. Peace, love, and light to you all. Until we can do it again tomorrow.